Welcome back, my dear students. I hope you are fine. Now you are enjoying the online class. And now already we have started the point of syllabus. Okay, now let's go to the lesson to discuss. I'm Jero Haman, teacher of Mile Stone School and College, Sector 14, Uttara Dhaka. Today, what I will teach, that one is profit and loss. So today's topic is profit and loss, that means profit loss. And today's lecture is 37. An example number today we'll solve. 16-17, exercise 2.2, page number 33 and 34. Already we have solved, that is 9 previous lesson, 9, example number 9, 11 and 13. Today this one we have to solve. I hope previous lesson we have understood. And today, before solving this mass, so first we'll learn the definition, some definition. So what is cost price? The purchasing price of anything is called cost price. What is called cost price? The purchasing price of anything is called cost price. That means when you purchase, when you buy something, that one is called cost price. So what is selling price? The selling price of anything is called selling price. When you sell something, that one is called selling price. If the selling price is more than the cost price, then it is profitable. We can tell. That means selling price is more and cost price is less. So obviously that one is profit. So we can write selling price minus cost price if you want to find the profit. Okay, if you want to find the profit, then selling price obviously will be more and cost price will be less. That means if you want to find the profit, you have to subtract cost price from selling price. If the selling price is less than the cost price, at that time there is a loss. When it is loss, then obviously cost price is more and selling price will be less. So you can, if you want to find the loss, that means cost price minus selling price you have to write. That means cost price will be more. That's why you have to subtract selling price from cost price. And VAT, full form of VAT, value added tax. Tax given, and what is actually VAT? Tax given at a fixed rate with the cost price of a thing is called VAT. So actually the what is tax, you don't know, but you are giving the tax to the government. A compulsory contribution to state revenue levied by the government on workers' income and business profit, or added to the cost of some goods, services, and transaction, etc. Okay, that means when you give, that means when you buy something, we are giving the tax. Now, when you say the percent, we are really saying per hundred. Percent means for every hundred or out of hundred, the percent symbol, this one is the percent symbol. Okay, this one is the percent symbol. Symbol as a quick way to write a fraction with a denominator of 100. Okay, that means if you write 2%, that means 2 by 100, like this. So today we'll solve example number 16, page number 33. The example number 16 is, a goat is sold at a loss of 10%. If the selling price is 450 more, then it is 5% profitable. So what is the cost price? We have to find the cost price. Again, you have to read the question. A goat is sold at a loss of 10%. Okay, loss 10% and selling price is more 450 taka when profit is 5%. So we have to find the cost price. Now let's solve the maths. So this one is the question, right? So already you have read this one, so we have to solve this. So we can write, suppose the cost price of the could be 100 taka. Suppose the cost price only the could be 100. For solving this mass, we can take this one. So here given the 10%, percent means out of 100, you know, right? So percent means out of 100, that means the if 10% loss, we can write out of 100 taka, that means the selling price what will be? 10% loss. You have sold 10% loss. Suppose the price of a coat is 100 taka. 10% already you have lost. So you have sold, this one is 90 taka, obviously, right? So we can write, in 10% loss, the selling price is 100 minus 10, right? It will be 90 taka. Now, if we write, that means the 5% profit, what will be the selling price? 5% profit. So when it is profit, you have to add. When it is loss, you have to subtract, right? So now 5% profit, the selling price is 100 plus 5. It will be 105. Okay. Now, so what is the, that is the, how much is more, that is more selling price is how much. So more selling price, we can get. The selling price is in 5% profit minus the selling price in 10% loss. So what will be this one? This one is more selling price is 105 minus 90. That means we can subtract. If we want to find the more selling price, it will be 105 minus 90, or it will be 15 taka. This one is the more selling price. So if this 15 taka more selling price, do you know what is the cost price? 100 taka, right? This 100 taka, the when selling price is more 15 taka, that means out of 100 taka, right? So if the selling price is 15 taka more, the cost price is 100 taka. If the selling price is 15 taka more, that means the cost price is 100 taka. Already you have taken, right? The cost price is 100. So already you have find out the 15 taka is more selling price. Okay, between these two requirements, 10% loss and 5% profit, this one. So now we can find this one. So if selling price is 1 taka, so what will be the cost price? Obviously, if you want to find the 1 taka, it will be divided, that means 100, it will be 100 by 15, right? You know this one. So 100 by 15 you can write. If the selling price is 1 taka, you know that means 1 taka selling price is more, that means obviously cost price will be less. So when it is less, you have to divide 100 by 15. So if the cost price is 450 taka more, if the cost price is 450 taka more, that means what will be the cost price? 100 into, that means 450, we have to multiply, because now selling price is more than 1, right? So we have to multiply this one. You have to find this one. This one is multiplication, right? So now we have to cut this one. So 15, we can cut this one. Then 15 and 45, we can multiply this one. 40, that means 3, 30, we can multiply this one, right? 30 into 15, we get 450, right? So what will be the now? 30 into 100, we have to multiply this one. What will we get? 30 into, we'll get this one. $3,000, right? 100 into 30, you will get 3,000. So the selling price, when 450 taka more, at that time the cost price will be 3,000. So we can write, so the cost price of the goat is 3,000. Okay, have you understood this one? Okay. If you don't understand, again you'll watch this video, okay, and pause your video and try to understand this one. So when the cost price is 15 taka more, okay, the selling price is 15 taka more, then the cost price is 100. When it's 1 taka, obviously it will be divide. When 450 taka, because 450 taka is more than 1, so it will be multiplied. Just multiply this one, you'll get 3000. So we can write the cost price of the good is 3,000. Now we'll solve the next. So next one is, example number 17. Example number 17, now we have to solve. And example number 17 is what? Nabil bought 2 kgs of sundaes at the rate of 250 taka per kg. Per kg. Per kg means 1 kg. Per kg means 1 kg. 1 kg sundaes price is 250 taka. From a sweet shop, if the rate of VAT is 4 per 100, that means out of 100 taka, VAT is 4 taka. Already you know the VAT is value added tax, right? So that means out of 100 taka, we have to give 4 taka. And we have to give, actually, we are giving, that we are contributing to the state of VAT, right? When you buy something. So how much did he pay to the shopkeeper? Okay, now we have to solve this one. And first we have to find out this one. So 1 kg, you know, the price of 1 kg shundaes here given is 250 taka, right? Here 2 kg shundaes at the rate of 250 per kg. Here given the per kg, right? Given the per kg, that means I will mark this one here, 250 per kg. That means in 1 kg, 250 taka. So he Nabil bought 2 kg shundaes, right? 2 kg shundaes. So the price of 1 kg shundaes is 250 taka. So we have to find, so 1 kg is 250 taka. So what will be the price of 2 kg? So 2 kg shundaes, it will be 250 into 2. That means you will get is in 500 taka, right? So already you got the 2 kg shundaes on 500 taka. So here given how much did he pay to the shopkeeper? So did he pay, actually did he pay only 500 taka? No. So here given the VAT, actually when you buy something, not only you are giving the goods, the which one you are buying, that means the things, not you are giving the VAT also, okay, including the cost price of the things, you are giving the VAT. So here given the rate of VAT is 4 taka, right? That means out of 100 taka, we are giving the VAT 4 taka. So now, how many taka will I give this one? First, we solve this one. So, one VAT for 100 taka. VAT for 100 taka is 4 taka. VAT for 100 taka, that means out of 100 taka, we are giving 4 taka. Okay, so in 1 taka, so obviously when you find this 1 taka, that means 100 taka, VAT for 100 taka, you are giving 4 taka. So when you find the 1 taka, obviously you are giving the less. So when it is less, it will be divide. So 4 by 100. So when you are finding the 1 taka, VAT for only 1 taka, it will be 4 by 100. So but when you find, that means the what was the cost price of the thing? What was the cost price? 500 taka already you got, right? So 500 taka. So how much taka will you give this one? So now find this one. 4 into 500. This 500 you have to multiply with 4. So this one will get. Now we have to cut this one. So this 100, this one is 500. So we can cut this one by 5, right? We can cut this one by 5. So 5, 4 are how many taka? 5, 4 are 20 taka. That means we are giving VAT 20 taka. So just 20 taka you are giving the VAT, but we have to keep the cost price of this 500 taka, right? 500 taka, the cost price of the thing, that means the shown this 500 taka and 20 taka we have to give more is that. So total now Nabil paid 500 plus 20. It will be 520 taka to the shopkeeper. That means Nabil give 520 taka. Okay. So now, have you understood, students? I hope you better understand this one. Okay. Because this one is easy, right? VAT out of 100 taka is 4 taka, 1 taka 4 by 100. So 500 taka just you have the cost price of the future is only 500 taka. So VAT 100 taka is 4 taka. So 500 taka, 20 taka we have to give. So 500 plus 20, it will be 520 taka you have to give this. Okay, now the next one, activity 1, page 34. Now, like the previous class, you have to solve this one. Do yourself this maths. Everyone, pause your video and solve this one. Can you solve or not? Okay. Then again, was this video? Okay. Again, was this class? Then I will solve this problem. Actually, now check your maths by activity one what I given. So now I am solving this one. So now going to a shari shop, Kona bought a silk shari at taka 1200 and a 3-piece at taka 1800. If the rate of VAT is 4%, so how much taka will she pay to the shopkeeper? The same way, that means, right? So that means here given the Kona bought a silk shari is this taka. Right, this taka, that means 1200 taka this one, and three piece the price of 3-piece was this one 1800. So total he spent how much taka so total he spent one, that means we have to add this one 1200 and 1800 we have to add this one. Total he spent 3000 taka. The same way the previous month is same. So here given the VAT is 4 taka, right? So out of 100 taka, VAT is 4 taka, so 1 taka, so 3000 taka. Just like this, you have to find this one. Okay. Now, VAT for 100 is 4 taka, that means, right? So in 1 taka, it will be 4 by 100. And here the VAT is, that means total he spent is 3000 taka. So 3000 taka, how much taka did he pay the VAT? Okay, so it will be 4 into 3000 and by 100. So just cut this one, this 3000, and if you cut this one, you will get 30, right? Just 30. So just multiply 4 into 30, it will be 120, right? 4, 3 are 12, so there is 10, just write like this. Okay. So it will be total bet is 120 taka. But did she only 120 taka? No. The total cost of sari and three pieces is 3000 and along with bet is 120 taka. So total she paid 3000 plus 120, that means 3120 taka total she paid. Okay. Now I hope you have solved yourself this mess, because previous mess when you solve, then you can solve yourself this one. It's very easy for you. Now today's SW is 37, and SW is 37. Which one? Now this one is example number 15, 18, and 19 of exercise 2.2, page number 33 to 35. Okay, and after solving this mess, you submit your subject teacher. Okay, I hope you enjoy this class and understood this class also. Okay, thank you very much for watching this one.